The woman with the issue of blood, when she was coming to Jesus, the Bible said she heard about the Lord, she heard about Christ, and she said to herself, if I should but touch the hem of the garment of the Lord, I will be healed of this problem that has plagued me for 12 solid years. I've wasted all my resources and nothing is happening. Hallelujah. So she came with faith. She came with an expectation. We can find that one in the book of Mark. In the book of Mark, chapter 5, 25 to 29. Hallelujah. She came with faith. She came with expectation. She came believing and trusting that if she could touch the hem of the garment of Jesus, she will have her problem solved. And of course, when she came and she did it, she had her result. She had the healing that she was trusting the Lord for. Having spent all her money on doctors or physicians, and she was not getting better. The Bible put it right. It said, even though she was spending all her living, she was spending all her resources on doctors, visiting one doctor from one doctor to another doctor, she was not getting any better. She was rather getting worse until the day she heard about the Lord Jesus Christ. And she told herself, I have faith, I have trust, I have confidence, I have hope that if I should touch the hem of the garment of this man, I will not remain the same again. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Many people were following Jesus. The Bible said the crowd were following him. Yet this woman was able to make her way through. She broke through and touched the hem of the garment of Jesus. Hallelujah. There were four friends that came with a man crippled from birth. In the book of, a man who was crippled, placed at the beautiful gate. They strategically located this man at the beautiful gate in Jerusalem, so that when people were going into the temple to worship the Lord, they will have pity on him, they will have mercy on him, they will deal out something to him, they will give him an arm. And the Bible said one day, John and Peter were making their way to the same temple to pray. Hallelujah. And when they got there, the man looked at them with an expectation. I love the Bible say he looked at them expecting something. But this particular day, God was going to God was going to give to this man more than what he was expecting. He was expecting money. But that day, God was going to turn his life around. That day, God was going to change his condition. And I love the way the Bible said he was expecting to receive something from Peter. But Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give to you. In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. And the man who had never walked, hallelujah,
amen,
he got up and began to walk. And the Bible said, for the first time, he went to the temple. Hallelujah. Today, may somebody receive the word of God,
amen,
with an expectation,
yes,
that something good will happen to him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. And we are assured in scripture, we are told in the word of God, that the expectation, the hope, the expectation of the righteous shall be gladness. Amen. Somebody say, my expectation shall be gladness. My expectation shall not fail. The Bible said the expectation of the righteous shall not be frustrated, shall not be cut off. It shall come to pass, because that expectation is hinged on something. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Your expectation shall not be cut off. I don't know what you are expecting God to do for you, but I'm here to tell you, if it took God 40 years to do something for somebody, I am here to tell you that God will do something better for you.
Amen.
I don't know what you are trusting and believing God for. Don't think it is too late. It's never too late.
Never.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I say it's never too late.
It's never too late.
It took God 40 years to open a door for somebody.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
It took Moses 40 years,
yes,
to go back to what God planted in his spirit,
yes,
to do in the land of Egypt. It took God 40 years.
Yes.
Moses ran away from Egypt at the age of 40. But before he went back to Egypt to do what God planted in his spirit, it was after 40 years when he was at the age of 80.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Keep your faith.
Amen.
Keep your expectation.
Amen.
God will fulfill it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And then in the book of Proverbs, that is Proverbs 10:28, it says, the hope of the righteous shall not shall be gladness. Have you put it there? Proverbs 10:28. Put it there for me.
The hope of the righteous shall be glad.
Yes.
But the expectation of the wicked shall
perish. The expectation of the wicked shall perish. The hope of the righteous, which is the same as the expectation. Or the conviction of the righteous, or the confidence of the righteous. That is why the Bible said in Hebrews 10:35, cast not away your confidence. Cast not away your confidence. Your confidence is not in man.
Yes, Lord.
Your confidence is not in the head of a state.
Yes.
Your confidence is not in the president.
Yes.
Your confidence is not in the prime minister.
Yes.
Your confidence is not in the political party.
Yes.
Your confidence in Jehovah God.
Yes.
The one who created the heavens and the earth.
Yes.
The one who said, let there be and there was.
Yes.
The God who cannot lie. The Bible says he cannot lie. Brethren, do you know why God cannot lie?
He cannot lie.
The reason why God cannot lie is whatever God says is.
Hallelujah.
Whatever God says is. If, for example, I'm a man.
Yes.
If God says I'm a woman, I will turn into a woman straight up because God cannot lie. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you are sitting in front of me, if God says you are sitting behind me, you will move away straight away and come behind me. Because whatever God says is.
Hallelujah.
God cannot lie. So when he gives his word, the Bible says in Jeremiah 1:12, he's watching, I'm watching over my word. I am watching over my word to perform it. So when God gives you a word, my brother, hold on. When God gives you a word, hold on. For God is well able. God is well able. God is well able. Hallelujah. God is well able. He's able to fulfill his word. Hallelujah. Now we want to look at four things that helped this woman to snatch her miracle. Four things from the story we read. We want to look at four things that helped the woman to snatch her miracle. Hallelujah. And I'm here to say the first thing is that the woman was a chosen vessel for divine visitation.
Hey.
Somebody say, chosen vessel
for divine
visitation. Hallelujah. Reverend Ebenezer Ablorh, you see, God does not need permission.
Yes, Lord.
To make a choice.
Yes.
God does not need permission.
I believe it.
God does not need parliamentary approval. God does not need royal approval. God does not need royal decree. God does not need to consult anybody. Before choosing you for a miracle, before choosing you for a breakthrough,
yes.
Hallelujah. The Bible said the woman was chosen. No, the woman was specifically chosen. She was divinely chosen. Her choice came from God. It didn't come from anybody. It didn't come from the King of Israel. It came from Jehovah God. She was chosen. And the Bible said, I am a chosen generation. I am a chosen generation. God has chosen you. God has chosen me. God has chosen us for a divine visitation. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The woman was chosen. Somebody said she was chosen. Because there was somebody called the God of choice.
God of choice.
God of choice doesn't look at people where they come from. He doesn't look at their background. He doesn't look at their qualification. He doesn't look at their degrees. He doesn't look at the degrees they are holding. He doesn't look at the school they attended. God of choice can choose anybody. In fact, the Bible said the thing that are rejected, the thing that are abhorred, the thing that are despised, the thing that people don't have any respect for, those are the things that God chooses. If somebody is despising you, you are the candidate for God. If somebody is despising you, I say you are God's candidate for divine visitation. You are God's candidate for choice. Hallelujah. We are serving the God of choice. One of the titles of God is that he is the God of Abraham, he is the God of Isaac, and he is the God of Jacob. All right? Is that right? It means he's the God of choice.
Yes.
It was God. God went out of his own way and chose Abraham.
Yes.
God chose Abraham when he was worshiping idols. Ah, Reverend Ebenezer, Nimba will tell you, I was brought up in a fetish home. We were worshiping idols, eating God's food offered to idols. Food offered to idols was our food. The idols will eat and they will go and collect and eat. Hallelujah. But at the fullness of time, somebody say, at the fullness of time, the God of Israel,
the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob,
who is the God of choice, he chose me to be a vessel. He chose me for divine visitation. He chose me for favor. He chose me for mercy. He chose me to prove himself strong. He chose me to tell the world that he is God and that he does what he likes. The Bible says, why? He's the sovereign God in the heavens. Psalm 115 verse 3. He said, he's the sovereign Lord. He lives in heaven and he does what he pleases on earth.
Yes.
May God do something for you today.
Yes,
may God choose you out of the blues. May God choose you out of nowhere. May God choose you because you are despised. May God choose you because people are looking down upon you. May God choose you because you are a candidate for divine visitation. Amen. Now, I feel God is the God of choice. And he chooses them to do things for his glory. Hallelujah. What is it? The hope. No, my sister, you still. Hallelujah. Now, let's read Luke. Luke chapter 4, 25 to 26. I am telling you that the woman was chosen. The woman was not an Israelite. The woman was a Sidonian. She was from the region of Sidon. And the Sidon, we are told, is the place where Jezebel, that was the territory of Jezebel.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
hallelujah. Look at it. But I tell you of a truth. Many widows were in Israel in the days of Elias, when the heavens was shut up 3 years and 6 months, when great famine was throughout all the land. Let's go to 26. But unto none of them was Elias sent. God, they were not chosen. Somebody said they were not chosen. All the Israelites who qualified, who were the seed of Abraham, and by virtue of the seed of Abraham, being the seed of Abraham, they were qualified to be chosen. But God ignored them. God rejected them. And God chose the woman from Sidon. The woman from Zarephath. God chose her. Hallelujah. And you are serving the God of choice. I prophesy over your life that God will lift other people and choose you. He's the God of choice. I say he will choose you. God will choose you for any position. God will choose you. He will qualify you. He will prepare you. Hallelujah. Do you know the song they sing? Lord, prepare me to be sanctuary, pure and holy. You. May God prepare Manna Mission Church in the city of UK. Hallelujah. In the city of, what is the place name of it? Back. May God prepare you and lift you up. May God prepare you and honor you and bring you to the place where your influence, where your authority will be fed by everybody. Hallelujah. Because you are serving the God of choice. Amen. God is still in the business of choosing people. If God chose this woman from Zarephath to showcase her, to show his glory, to demonstrate his power through this woman, then I say, I prophesy over you that you are the next in God's line of choice. God is going to choose you. Something good is going to come your way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The woman was chosen by God for divine visitation. Let's go to John chapter 9, 1 to 3. John chapter 9, the book of John chapter 9. Another man was chosen for God's glory to be manifested through him. Please, I am speaking, I'm saying how to snatch your miracle through expectation. And I start by saying that the woman was chosen, divinely chosen by God for divine visitation. Hallelujah. When God chooses you, you are on his agenda. It is a matter of time. Hallelujah. It is a matter of time. Tell your brother, it's a matter of time. Tell him, I've already been chosen. The devil has lost on me. Yeah, because God has already chosen me for divine visitation. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Look at it. He said, and as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Amen. Jesus answered, neither had this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works, you see, the man was chosen to be born blind. Amen. Hallelujah. You see, you don't understand the divine orchestrations of God. These are the doings of God. These are things that come from God alone and God alone. Hallelujah. Amen. The man was chosen so that what? The works of God should be made manifest in him. Amen. The woman of Zarephath was chosen. God left all the Israelite women. God left all the widows in Israel and went to Zarephath and chose this woman. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. So he's the God of choice. So to snatch your miracle through expectation, you must be chosen by God. Amen. God must choose you. And all of us here are chosen. According to 1 Peter 2, 9, we are the chosen generation. God has chosen us, and therefore we are on God's agenda for divine visitation. Amen. The second point I want to talk about is that God has spoken, or God has given his word. Hallelujah. God gave his word to both the prophet and the woman. See, let me tell you something. When you are in church and somebody comes to tell you, God says, you must do this, check your spirit if God has already spoken to you. But God will not make a mistake. God will not tell you to give your car to somebody when he has not talked to you about it. God will not tell you to give your house to somebody or to the church when God has not spoken to you. What the person comes to tell you should be a witness, an inward witness, a confirmation that God has spoken to you. Because when the woman came, when the man came, he said, God told him, he said, I have given my word to the woman, a widow woman in Zarephath. I've given my word to him, her already, and I'm giving my word to you to go there. So the two of them, God spoke to them at different times. Hallelujah. So God has spoken his word. God has given his word. Hallelujah. The word of God. Now, every miracle, I want you to believe, I want you to know this. Every miracle in scripture begins with a word from the Lord. In fact, there is no faith until God has released a word.
Yes, Lord.
Because the Bible says faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Hallelujah. So God, make sure God has spoken. So God said, I've given my word to the woman, and I'm giving my word to you to go to the woman. Hallelujah. So God gave his word. There is no expectation of a miracle until the word of God or the seed of the word has been declared by Almighty God. God's word is powerful, creative. Hebrews 4:12. Give me Hebrews 4:12. No, give me Hebrews. Yeah, Hebrews 4:12. Please give me Hebrews 4:12 quick. God's word is powerful. God's word is creative. God's word can do anything. So to expect a miracle, you must have the word of God. God must declare his word. Hallelujah. He said, for the word of God is what? Quick. It means it is alive and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and of the joints and marrow, and is discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart of man. God's word is powerful. God's word is creative. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Until God gives his word, don't live in expectation of anything. God's word is powerful. And when God gives his word, anything about anything which includes a situation which is not even in existence, it shall come to pass. Hallelujah. I said God's word is so powerful that when God tells you about something which is not even in existence, that thing can come into existence. Amen. Because the word of God can create. Whatever what God says, the word can create if the thing is not already there. You remember when Jesus went to the beach in the book of Luke chapter 5. He met Peter washing his net, getting ready to go home. Peter has fished all night. Amen. Peter, as a seasoned fisherman, has fished all night. Then Jesus went to the beach and he went into Peter's boat and asked Peter to push the boat a little into the sea, so that Jesus could minister to the people. And after ministering to the people, he asked Peter to get into the boat, take the nets, and go back into the sea where he has fished the whole night and he caught nothing. Peter said, Master, what you are saying is difficult, because I, as a seasoned fisherman, I who know when fishes come out to eat and then we get them, I have gone the whole night and I've caught nothing. Now you are asking me to go back to the same place. But what Peter didn't know was that because the master has spoken, even though the fish were not there, he commanded it. The word he spoke created them.
Yes,
hallelujah. So when God gives his word to you about something which is not in existence, please go and sleep. It shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. Because the word can create the situation.
Amen.
God's word can create anything. Hallelujah. Oh, somebody say the word of God creates. Now let's look at Psalm 33. The word of God is irresistible. Nobody can stop the word of God. Amen. The word of God, nobody can fight and stop the word of God from coming into fulfillment. Psalm 33, 8 and 9. Let's look at Psalm 33 quickly. This is a teaching service. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let me quickly run through these points. Psalm 33, 8 and 9. Look at it. He said what? Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the inhabitants of the world stand in awe of him. For he spake and it was done. He commanded and it stood fast. Hallelujah. When God speaks, that is the end. When God declares you innocent, you are innocent. When God declares you righteous, you are righteous. When God declares you blessed, you are blessed. Hallelujah. When God commands his blessing upon you, nobody can curse you. You know when Balak wanted to curse the people of God, he was hired by Balak to curse them. God said, these people cannot be cursed because I've already pronounced blessing upon them. Hallelujah. You are blessed, and therefore that cancels every curse that anybody is trying to bring against your life. Amen. God's word accomplishes his desires. In Isaiah 55, 10 and 11, he says, let's go to Isaiah 55, 10 and 11 quickly, then we can move forward, we can make progress. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Isaiah, yes, he said, for as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please. Hallelujah. And it shall prosper in the thing that I have sent. My brother, my sister, once God has spoken, I want you to rely and depend upon it. It shall never fail you. God's word will never fail you. God will never disappoint you, because he says, the word that goes out of my mouth shall never come back void. It shall come back accomplishing the thing that I have designed. I have designed the word to do. Amen. Now, the widow we are talking about, heard the word of the Lord. God told him, hey, that I am sending my prophet, I am sending my man to you, because there is no food in the land. Let me tell you, do you think the Bible said that the brook dried up, isn't it? That was how God was sending Elijah away from the brook. Do you think God cannot sustain the brook? Can't God sustain the brook? The Bible didn't talk about the ravens stopping to bring the food. The Bible only talked about the brook drying up. Because the ravens were bringing the food all the time, but there was no water. God utterly caused the water to dry up because God wanted to save somebody's life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You see, when Isaac, in the book of Genesis chapter 26, the Bible said everybody's land, there was no rain, nothing. But Isaac planted, and he alone had his things grew and harvested. Where was the water coming from? God can cause water to come. But there's a reason. God knows the woman will believe the word. That's why he didn't send Elijah to any widow in Israel. Because they will not believe it. Widows. But he didn't send the Elijah to any of them because they won't believe his word. They will joke with his word. Let me tell you, if you are a man, a woman, and you joke with the word of God, you don't tremble at the word of God, God will put you aside. He will set you aside. God is looking for people who tremble at his word. God is looking at people who fear him and love him and respect his word. He will send his word to you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So God sent his word to the woman, and the woman believed. The widow heard God's word clearly. She believed and acted upon it to snatch her miracle. Faith is said to be a fact, but faith is an action. Hallelujah. If you say you believe and you don't practicalize your belief, you don't put your belief system into action, you have lost the game. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. In the book of Mark, chapter 2, verse 5, the Bible said, Mark chapter 2, verse 5, my sister, Mark chapter 2, verse 5, the Bible said, when Jesus saw their faith, let's go to it. Look at it. When Jesus saw their faith, can you see faith? Can you see faith? Faith is an abstract, but can you see faith when it is demonstrated?
Yes.
You can only see faith when it is enacted.
Yes.
So, in this one, the people went to the roof and removed it. The Bible described, the Bible said Jesus interpreted their action as faith. He saw their action and he described or interpreted the action as faith. Faith is acting. So when the widow heard the word of God, hallelujah. When the widow heard the word, hallelujah. God, our Father, said to watch over, he said to watch over his word to perform it. So when the widow heard the word, she believed it. Amen. She believed it. Somebody said she believed it. And because of her believing, she acted upon the word. Hallelujah. The prophet of God has spoken God's word. You know, when the prophet came, God has given his word. There must be a confirmation. For the woman to know that she is not mistaken. For the woman to believe that she is walking in obedience to what God has told her. The man of God who came must also speak the word of God. What God has told the woman, the man must speak the same thing. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So the prophet of God has also spoken God's word. So first, the woman was chosen. Number two, she received the word of God. Number three, the prophet also came to speak the word to confirm that what she heard was true and was coming from God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, somebody here. So the true prophet is the spokesperson for the Lord God Almighty. The true prophet declares what God has spoken or what God has communicated to him. A true prophet's word is as good as the word spoken by the Lord himself. The prophet represented the interests of God here on earth, and therefore God honors or fulfills the predictions of his prophets. Hallelujah. The prophet was sent by God to go and speak to this widow and tell the widow what was going to happen. When the man came, he also spoke the same thing to them. Hallelujah. We are told in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 20 verse 20. 2 Chronicles 20:20. When the man of God speaks as a servant of God, and it is the word of God, you must believe it. Look at it. 20:20 say, and they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah. Hear ye me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, so you shall be what? You shall be what? If you believe in the Lord, nothing can move you. If you believe in the Lord, there's no economic crisis that can shake you. If you believe in the Lord, there's no storm of life that can shake you. There's no storm of life that can sweep you away. If you believe in the word of the Lord and you are standing on the word of the Lord, you will never be swept away by any flood. Hallelujah. Because the word of the Lord can sustain you. You see, that's the reason why the word of God is so powerful. Reverend Ebenezer Ablorh, you know when Peter wanted to walk on the water, Peter wanted to make sure, because Peter has tested the Lord once. At in Luke 5, he said, go. And he said, at your word. You see, I've toiled all night, but at your word, I want to go. Now, when he came to Matthew chapter 14, when he was about to walk on the water, he wanted to make sure, because he knows the word of the Lord will not fail. Hallelujah. He knows the word of the Lord will not fail. So he said, Jesus, if it is you, Jesus, bid me to come. Ask me to come and I will stand on that word. I will never sink. Hallelujah. Tell me something. Peter said, Lord, if it is you, the Lord, save me. Bid me. Say, come. And Jesus said, come. That come was able to hold the water, solidify the water under the feet of Peter to walk on it. Hallelujah. I said, the word of God will create every situation that you need. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So he said what? Believe ye his prophet and ye shall do what? Prosper. Believe the prophet. It means obey. Another translation says obey his prophets. You see, you believe in God, will be established. You obey what his prophets say and prosperity will come. But make sure the man is speaking the word of God. Otherwise, they will come and dupe you and take your money away. Make sure God, he's speaking the word of the Lord. Make sure you have also heard from God. If I come and tell you, God says, you should give your car to me. If they come from Africa to tell you that, tell them God has not spoken to you. Tell them you haven't heard from God yet. And the day you hear from God, you will drive the car to his house. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yes, you will ship it at your own cost. They won't pay anything. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So the prophet speaks God's word accurately, which the Lord has spoken, and will always have the benefit. Amen. So the woman believed the word of the prophet. So we are saying that she was chosen because there were many widows. God chose her for divine visitation. God's word was declared. God declared his word to the prophet. Hallelujah. God told the prophet what he was going to do. And God told the woman, the widow, what he was going to do. And then number three, we said the prophet also spoke the same word. And the woman believed. The woman acted upon it. And then number four, the fourth point. The widow of Zarephath was acutely aware of the law of harvest. Hallelujah. The law of harvest. What does the law of harvest say? Give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will God cause men to give unto your bosom. What does the law of harvest say? It says, as long as the earth remaineth, seed time and harvest shall not cease. Hallelujah. If you sow, you will reap. If you don't sow, you will never reap. So the woman understood that for her to harvest, for her to receive a harvest from what she has to sow the seed first. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, let's go to Genesis 8:22. Praise the Lord. The widow was aware of the law of harvest. The law of harvest said you must sow before you reap. You must part company with what you have. And I want to assure you that whatever you give out of your life is not going away from your life. It will return into your life again. I am here to testify of the goodness of God. Amen. I believe in sowing and reaping. You don't sow, you don't reap. If you if you fear to sow, you will never have any harvest. You will never have any meaningful harvest. Harvest that can change your life. Harvest that can transform you. Harvest that can do many things. People will see and they will say, yes, this is the doing of the Lord in your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So the woman, have you put it there? Yes, look at this. Say, why the earth remained, seed time and harvest, and cold and heat, and summer and winter, and day and night shall not cease. These are divine pronouncements. These are divine pronouncements from God. As long as we live in this earth, the only way for us to receive blessing from God is for us to sow first. Look, if becoming prosperous comes through prayer, like the prayer warriors, all prayer warriors will be champions. Hallelujah. But there are principles. If you want to be prosperous, it comes by sowing. So the woman understood the law of harvest. She did not only understand the law of harvest, she also understand that the law of harvest operates according to proportion. If you give all, you will reap all. If you sow sparingly, the Bible says in, I think, 2 Corinthians 9:6. 2 Corinthians 9:6. If you sow bountifully, you will reap bountifully. If you sow sparingly, you will reap sparingly. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 9:6. By this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also what? And he which soweth bountifully shall reap what? Hallelujah. So the woman, look at it. The woman understood the law of harvest, that if you don't sow, you won't reap. If you don't give, you won't receive. If you don't part with something, something will not come into your life. So she understood. So when the man of God went there, the man of God said to the woman, go and prepare me first. Prepare a cake for me first. Hallelujah. So the woman did not only understand the law of harvest, she did not only understand that the law of harvest operates by proportion, she also understood what we call the principle of first things first. Somebody say first things first. First things first. When you are dealing with God, you must follow God in a certain order. God, we were told by Brother Frank in fellowship, he said in heaven the first thing is order. The first thing in heaven, he always told us in fellowship, that the first thing in heaven is order. First things first. If you don't do first, if you do first things second, and you do second things first, you won't get the result. Hallelujah. So the man of God said, look at, let's go back to 2 Kings, I think verse, no, 1 Kings, I think chapter 8, verse 16. Let's look at 1 Kings 16. 1 Kings 17, 16. 1 Kings 17, 16. We want to look at let's look at it. Say what? No, where he said first? Let's go to 17. I think 17. 17. 17, 17. Where he said, give me first. No, let's go back. Let's go to 15 and see. And they went and did according. Yes. Let's go to 16 and see. Why he said, prepare me first. Very good. 13. And said, therefore, little cake. No, prepare, but make me thereof a little cake first. Look, if the woman didn't do that, the miracle would not have happened. If she disobeyed that order, first things first order. You see, when you come to the house of God, the Bible said there are certain things you have to do first. If you don't do first things first, the miracle, the breakthrough will never happen. The man said, make me first. And the woman obeyed because God has spoken his word. The woman believed the word. The woman trusted the word of God. And so when the man said, bake me first a cake, she went and did that. Hallelujah. Now, these are the what you call the law of first principles. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Amen. Matthew 6:33. The Bible says, give and it shall be given unto you. So you give first before you receive. You seek the kingdom first before the other things will be added unto you. Jesus himself said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Brethren, if we want to snatch our miracle from God with great expectation, then we must learn to do first things first. We must learn to know that we must sow before we reap. We must plant before we harvest. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. So these are the four principles that we are learning from the woman of Zarephath. That number one, to snatch your miracle with expectation, first God must speak his word. No, first God must choose you. It begins with the choice of God. Second, God must give his word, because it is the word that will bring what God has said into being, into manifestation. You must believe the word and act upon the word. Then a servant of God, the servant of God will also have to release or confirm the word that the Lord has spoken to you. The Lord, the servant of the Lord who comes to you to release the blessing into your life or bring the miracle into your life, he must also speak the same word God has spoken to you in confirmation. Hallelujah. And then number four, you must know that the law, the breakthrough, the miracle you're expecting will come because you believe in the law of harvest. Amen. You must learn to give. You must learn to give to God. Pay your tithe. Bring your first fruit offering to God. Do first things first. Seek first the kingdom of God. And the Bible says all other things shall be added unto you. Jesus said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. If you do these things, the Lord will bring your miracle that you are expecting through your great expectation. Hallelujah. The woman had her expectation come to pass. The woman had her miracle because she was chosen by God for divine visitation. God has spoken, or God declared his word, and then the prophet also confirmed the word that the Lord has spoken, and the woman believed in the principle of sowing and reaping. So she carried out the instruction of the man of God, and she had her miracle, her breakthrough. Hallelujah. May the Lord help us. May the Lord choose us. May the Lord send forth his word, for the word of the Lord is able to bring into manifestation whatever the Lord says. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Shall we bow down our heads for prayer? Our Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you for this afternoon. I bless and glorify your name for the opportunity given to me to divide your word. I have spoken as the oracles of God, what you lay upon my heart. And I've spoken with the utterance that you give to me to bless your people in the mighty name of Jesus. I ask for your blessing upon everyone that has come under the sound of my voice and has received the word. May we go and be doers of the word, not hearers only, deceiving ourselves. This is our prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.